Dear students, today we'll discuss the legislature. Let's recall what we learnt in the class 7. What is a constitution? Constitution is a set of rules and laws according to which a country is governed. Let's know who all are governing us. The executives, like the president, vice president, prime minister and his council of ministers. In India, the head of the state is the president, who is elected by the elected members of the two houses of the parliament and the state legislative assemblies. What are the organs of the government? Government has three organs: legislature, executive and judiciary. What is legislature? It is the law-making body. What is executive? It is the body that implements the laws and runs the government. What is judiciary? It protects the laws and ensures that the citizens get justice. The government at the center is called the union government. It consists of the president and the two houses of the parliament. Parliament consists of Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha and the president. Now we'll discuss what is Lok Sabha. The Lok Sabha is also known as the House of the People. It is the lower house of the parliament. What is the maximum strength of the Lok Sabha? Not more than 552 members. Out of 552 members, 530 are from the representatives of the states, 20 representatives of union territories, and 2 members are nominated by the President of India from the Anglo-Indian community. What is the present strength of Lok Sabha? Present strength is 545. The people directly elect members of the Lok Sabha. Depending on the population, each state has a fixed number of constituencies from the Lok Sabha. For example, from Odisha, 21 members are elected to Lok Sabha. So let's know what is constituency. It is a territorial areas set up for the purpose of election in each state. One candidate is elected from one constituency. They are called as Member of Parliament or MP. Next, what is the eligibility or what are the qualifications required to be a member of Lok Sabha? A person must be a citizen of India. He or she must be at least 25 years of age. He must be registered voter. He should not be a proclaimed criminal. He must be mentally sound. Now we'll discuss what is the term or tenure of the Lok Sabha. The term of the Lok Sabha is 5 years. It can be dissolved earlier during national emergency or if a no confidence motion is passed against the ministry. Now we'll know procedure for election. Voting is done by secret ballot. Let's know what is the meaning of the word secret ballot. Secret ballot, it is a system of voting where only the voter knows who he has voted for. Voting age of a person in India is 18 years or above. The voters give their opinion through EVM machine. Citizens voting on EVM. Through the EVM machine, they can choose a leader whom they think would be a good leader for them and for the country. Now we will discuss who is a speaker. The speaker is the presiding officer of the Lok Sabha who supervises the work of the house. He or she is selected by the house from among its members by a simple majority vote. The speaker may cast his or her vote only in case of a tie. Let's know who is the current speaker of the Lok Sabha. Mr. Om Birla is the speaker of Lok Sabha. Now we will discuss about Rajya Sabha. What is the composition of Rajya Sabha? 250 members are there in the Rajya Sabha, out of which 238 members represent the states and the union territories. Seats are allotted to each state according to its population. For example, from Odisha, 10 members are elected to the Rajya Sabha and 12 members are nominated by the President of India. From the field of art, literature, science and social service. Term or tenure of Rajya Sabha. Members of Rajya Sabha are elected for a period of 6 years. One third of its members retire every 2 years and their place is taken by newly elected members. What are the qualifications required to be a member of Rajya Sabha? He or she must be a citizen of India. He or she must be 30 years of age. His or her name should be in the electoral list. He should not hold any office of profit. The Vice President is the presiding officer of Rajya Sabha. His duties are similar to those of the Speaker of Lok Sabha. Let's know who is the current Vice President of India. Sri Venkaiah Naidu is the current Vice President of India and he is the Chairman of Rajya Sabha. Let's discuss about the functions of the Parliament. The most important function of the Parliament is lawmaking. While framing laws, certain procedures have to be followed. There are two kinds of bills. One is the ordinary bill and another one is money bill. So what is an ordinary bill? All the non-money bills are called as ordinary bills. It can be introduced in either the Lok Sabha or the Rajya Sabha unless and until the president gives his consent. A bill cannot be an act. What is a money bill? It can be introduced only in the Lok Sabha. It is referred to the Rajya Sabha for its approval. The speaker has to decide a bill is a money bill or not. The president has to give his permission before a bill is introduced in the Lok Sabha. After the money bill pass in the Lok Sabha, it is sent to the but the Rajya Sabha has only 14 days to accept the bill. If the Rajya Sabha does not return it in 14 days, it is considered passed by the Rajya Sabha. Then it will send to the president for his approval. Now we will discuss a comparative study between Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. Money bill introduced in Lok Sabha, but in Rajya Sabha has an only works as a advisory role. No confidence motion passed in Lok Sabha, but Rajya Sabha plays no role in no confidence motion. Lok Sabha is a temporary house, but Rajya Sabha is a permanent house. It cannot be dissolved in any circumstances. But there are some similar powers also with them. Both the houses play an important role in the election of the president and vice president. Both the houses play an important role in the impeachment of the president and judges of the Supreme Court and High Court.